Okay, so with the end of the Nuremberg 5th and 7th tournament, which ended in the victory of Nuremberg 7, we are now going to be giving the Champa arc a review. The Champa arc is episode 28 through episode 41. So let's get started. Can
If you
we both
enjoyed the
agree?
video, please subscribe and follow me on Twitter. Link in the description. Thanks
Let's
for
get
watching.
started. Can we both agree? Episode 30 is atrocious. It's the worst episode.
It was a waste of time, yes.
Complete waste of time. It's debatable what is worst, episode 5 or episode 30, but they're neck and neck for worst episode.
Yeah,
They really are. I mean,
true.
at least episode 5 contributed to the rehash. That episode was just there for, what was the purpose of that episode?
Wasn't it the episode where Vegeta and Goku showed up with beards? No, it was when it was the one where they were going to the time chamber.
No, it would be episode when they were recruiting people. But I remember that when they found Gohan training with
It
Piccolo.
was before they went to the time chamber, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, there was literally no point in that. Like there was literally only like 5 to 10 minutes of actual screen time besides rehashing. And when you did get that screen time, it was just them
It was just like,
repeating.
hey, Boo, why aren't you fighting the tournament? Gohan, you wanna fight? No, I have the conference.
Right.
That's all it was. Literally the only good thing about that episode was getting to see Gohan and Piccolo training.
True.
No, but I do want to point out they did this 2 times in Dragon Ball Z. They did do rehashes, but the difference is they did then once at the end of the Frieza arc and once at the end of the Cell arc. I emphasize the word end.
Right.
Not the beginning, they did it at the end. But because of the fact that they were just rehashing things, like, you can't do, like, a clip show at rehashing content in, like, the second episode of an arc. That doesn't make sense.
Wasn't it the third? It was the third.
Third. Great. That makes it so much better.
No, it just makes it less worse. You can't say this episode got better. That's not a word for this episode. It just got less worse. Because
It was just a clip
honestly,
show.
it's only like 20 more minutes of time you gave it into this arc before you decided to do a rehash on a rehash. It's just less worse,
Very
not better.
true. Very true. But we do need to talk, and I think and you can go first, Ed, about the tournament. I feel like we should start off with the fighters that were pissed at the tournament. How do you feel about the people that were selected and the fact that they went in without any real training in from like the god tier character?
I honestly think it was okay. It wasn't too bad when we. Oh, excuse me. So when you mean characters, are we talking about like opinions or like on the characters?
I'm talking about like how you felt about the Bisata Piccolo without any training just went into this tournament. And how you feel about the ones that they chose. Like do you think Boo was a good choice? Do you think it was reasonable for Gohan not to be picked? Stuff like that.
I personally think it was reasonable for Gohan not to be picked. He's not a character that's needed at this point.
True.
But when it comes to like picking Boo, I felt like it wasn't the smartest choice if they were gonna have a test beforehand on how smart you are. That was not the smartest choice
Yes, I
whatsoever.
also wanted to point out that would you really have been able to take Boo that seriously?
Boo would not have fought seriously in that
No,
tournament. That's
would
another
you
thing.
have even been able to take him seriously against like Boo versus Motama? Would you be able to take that seriously? I
No.
wouldn't. Like I just look
No.
at it, like big yellow fat guy versus the big pink fat guy. I mean, Boo just you have all these.
Excuse
What the hell? You have all these
Excuse me.
like, yeah. You have all these like powerful. Even Motama looked if either you, I can take Botama more seriously than I take Fatboo, honestly.
Okay, I mean, when it comes to characters, all characters that had to participate in the tournament participated. Like, all characters that were needed to. You mean for fan satisfaction, is what I'm saying. I mean, like, the characters that didn't participate, like Gohan, he wasn't really needed. Boo wasn't needed. No one even cared if Boo participated or not. No one was looking forward to that whatsoever.
Yeah, but that's, in my opinion, a stupid move. He's Boo, I mean.
Like, so, the characters that needed to be put in the tournament, like Goku, Vegeta, Piccolo, and Menaka, all those characters are characters that people wanted to see fight at least once in the tournament.
Very true. So, how did you feel about the way Piccolo lost?
I don't feel like I feel like it was very poorly plotted. Like, the
how do you feel about the fact that Piccolo wasn't allowed to enter the fight again?
I mean,
Goku won.
He just chose not to.
I do not remember the line that said, Piccolo, your loss had been deducted because of the fact that he cheated. I don't remember that ever being stated.
It was.
Oh, was it really?
Yeah, Piccolo's loss was deducted, and then Vegeta told Piccolo himself that he wanted to go next. He wasn't waiting for Piccolo to go.
Oh, yeah. To find out who was it? Magetta?
Yeah.
No, Frost.
Yeah, Frost. He basically kicked Frost's ass, then went on to Magetta.
Yeah, but the Piccolo still could. They could have done like a tag out, or they could have worked it in a way where Piccolo got the fight.
He had a fair fight. He had a good fight, now, not a fair one, but a good
why
one.
Why don't we talk about the elephant in the room with it? How did you feel about the fact that Gohan wasn't even there?
I don't think it had any relevance whatsoever. The fans who complained about
no,
that were mainly the
relevance Gohan isn't what's important fans right now, but the fact that Gohan isn't there.
What do you mean?
Hey, because the whole thing, the reason Gohan isn't fighting, is this is wife and child. They're there. In danger. Right now. They could die. Ciampa could decide, you know, screw all, you want to blow up the planet.
Wait, Videl was there?
Yeah, Videl and Peg were there. Videl and the baby were there, but Gohan wasn't.
I don't remember that.
Yeah, they were there the whole time.
He was at a conference. That's right.
The little crap. I'm sorry. I refuse to accept that. That was just crappy writing.
I think it was crappy.
No, because they needed an excuse for him not to fight. And that was the conference. So but you obviously couldn't have Gohan go then.
Right. They were looking for an excuse for him not to fight, that is for sure.
Obviously. I mean, they were, and that,
let's
but
go
they could have worked with it. They could have made him maybe show up a different way later. I mean, they could have done something.
Right. Let's transition into Universe 6. What do you personally think? You can go, and then I'll go. What do you personally think about the characters, or characters, development from the Universe 6 fighters, because there
but
definitely
the
was
character
somewhat that
they won. I think Botamo is a stupid concept and a stupid character. I hate Botamo.
He's not exactly the best character, that is for sure, yeah.
Did he even have a freaking line?
No, he did not, actually. I don't think he did. Botamo was pretty much the Yamcha of that tournament.
But even Yamcha did more in the Tenkaichi Budokai. Yamcha did more.
Yeah, but
Yamcha fought against Tien and got his leg broken.
Botamo doesn't really. He's not a needed character. He's more of like that empty slot, that empty fifth slot that they had to put in there.
True. Most likely. I will give them credit, though. His ability was cool.
Actually, now that you think about it, Botamo, and Magetta were the empty slots that they needed to put in there. There's really only three characters that they actually sort of focused on in this tournament.
No. But Nuets, can we all agree? Botamo's actual ability was amazing.
Botamo's actual ability was very amazing. The amount of durability on his body was crazy.
Yeah. Speaking of abilities, I do have a video I plan on doing eventually about Universe 6 versus Universe 7 outside of the tournament. But that's for another video. As you said, Botamo was Botamo. He didn't really say anything. So I guess now we're gonna talk about characters. Let's talk about their fight too. So the Botamo versus Goku fight was nothing.
It was. Comedic rather than.
It was just an insult of a fight. I can't form an opinion on it. It would be insulting to call it a fight.
It wasn't really a fight. It was more of like
It would literally be equivalent to the push-up that Beerus had Goku do in episode 42. That was all it was. With like Goku doing a small little workout. Botamo, the only fight that Goku did not transform in.
True.
Like, Botamo was so weak.
In the manga, he transformed against Botamo, didn't he? No.
No.
I can't remember.
He didn't transform until he fought Roth.
He transformed against somebody in the manga.
He transformed against Roth.
Yeah, but...
Like, he beat Botamo, and then him and Roth walked into the ring, and he transformed right away.
That's what I was thinking. Because I remember him transforming at some point in the manga before the anime. That was when the manga was actually sort of ahead of the anime.
Yeah, the good old days. Yeah. No, but I mean, legitimate here. Let's move on to Frost. Now, why don't you start with him?
Frost. He's a good character in a way. Bad and good. From the perspective that everybody wanted a good Frieza, bad. Like, he basically ruined a lot of expectations. People started to hate him. But, like, you and Geekdom have said before, his character's good in a way because you're supposed to hate the bad guy.
Yeah.
So,
That doesn't completely excuse that they wasted a good concept.
They did waste a good concept.
Yeah, the concept of Frost. The original Frost, that was a character they could have went with. They could have made that not be.
Of people actually liked Frost when he was good.
I'm pretty sure. I'm not sure if I was on air when I said it, but I said after that episode,
You told me Frost was your favorite character. I think you did.
Yeah, I said he was in my top like 10 favorite characters in the whole franchise.
Right, so far, at least what you said.
And then like a week later, I hate him. I mean, but what were your thoughts on, like, him and fight?
I didn't like the fact that they changed him from good to bad so quickly, and the fact that they did it in general, but I mean...
I think the problem was that Frost had this whole act going on. Like, nobody seems to mention it. No, he had this act, everybody from Universe 6. I don't think people realize, Hit could go back, Hit could take the, Hit after the tournament could have gone to everything, could have just gone around the universe and told everybody about Frost.
Right.
I mean, it doesn't make sense to me.
He broke his act in the middle of the fight.
He broke his act in front of five people from his own universe.
Six, if you include Vadis.
Yeah, and still four people that could.
There was actually a general audience though, wasn't there?
A small one, yeah. There were the Kai that's in universe.
Right. So
he also said it in front of Kabe, who is a Saiyan, and in universe six they protect the universe.
Right.
So, like, this thing going to the Emperor, they may go after his army now. Like,
Not only that, but the fact that Vegeta helped Kaba get Super Saiyan, that literally makes Frost, like, obsolete. That literally means Kaba could just fuck him up.
You're wrong. We don't know what his base power is.
Kaba? Kaba's base power is a match to Vegeta's.
True.
We know that.
Oh, God, you're right. He could just...
Yeah, Frost is fucked now.
Then again, didn't he take Frost out with Super Saiyan? No, that was Kaba.
Right. So, never I mind. Mean,
yeah,
Kaba
but,
could just fuck Frost
for me,
up right
the
now.
Thing with Brock, what Ed I said, it was I didn't like that they made him throw away his act. I didn't feel like... I felt like it made, literally... I know I say it a lot, but I mean it 100% of the time. It didn't make any sense from any perspective. It just didn't. There was no logical...
You're saying they could have done it better if they were going
to... No, they could have just had him not come out and give a whole monologue about how evil he is. And then start trying to kill Vegeta and everybody because he is evil. Because evil. You know what I mean?
Right.
I feel like they wanted to have an evil character. Like, they knew it wasn't necessarily going to be evil.
Right, right.
Like, they probably wanted to have somebody more that was evil.
I think they felt more so, like, if they didn't have an evil character in the arc, no one would feel any, you know, no one would feel any concern whatsoever, even though no one was gonna feel concerned in the first place, but you get what I'm saying.
Well, no, but I think we should just quickly talk about the fact that that Frost cheated. Like, did that bother you at all?
I honestly don't care, since his cheating literally became obsolete. Like, every fight he cheated on literally got redeemed.
No, but I mean, like, did it bother you that he took it at... Pretty much, Goku was defeated. I liked that. I liked the idea of Goku being defeated overall. I feel like it's very unique, like Goku losing and not defeating for, like, the final villain.
Goku loses quite often.
No, but he always gets up and fights again.
That is true.
Being Goku, they wasted an amazing opportunity here.
Right.
Imagine this. And it would be up to Piccolo, Vegeta, and Monaka to fight off that entire team.
There's a lot of people who wouldn't have been satisfied with that now, knowing that if that didn't happen, they wouldn't have gotten Kaioken times 10 in Super Saiyan.
No, but I don't really care about that. I care about that the word being that we're reviewing something, and it would have been better.
It definitely could have been better. I'm just saying satisfaction would have been lower.
Yeah, no, that's why they didn't do it.
Yeah.
But no, I feel like I want to move on. I don't want this video to be too long. I'm not like Geekdom where I make my arc reviews an hour and 30 minutes.
Did he honestly do that?
Yes, he did. Check out his video. You know what? Since I mentioned it, I'll put the link in the description. But you have all probably seen it. But I'll do it anyway, but... No, but let's move on to... Who came after Frost?
Magetta did.
Magetta. Well, what is there to say about Magetta? I really don't have too much of an opinion on Magetta.
No one really has an opinion on Magetta. He was less important than Botamo. In a way.
Yeah, I mean, he... And by the way, guys, we both know. I'm not sure if it's Magetta or Magetta. I am not sure.
It's Magetta.
No, I think I'm not sure if that's the Japanese official way of saying it.
Japanese, it might be Magetta.
Yeah, or Magetta. I don't know. The point is that Magetta. Was, in my opinion, irrelevant. And really just there to be there.
I mean, we did establish that earlier. There are two characters that were there just to be there. That's Magetta
and Jabba's fat ass.
Yeah. I feel like we're forgetting a fifth person here. No, we're not. No, we're not.
No, we're not.
For some reason, I felt I forgot that we talked about Cabba.
We did.
Right.
We didn't talk about Cabba.
So now on to Hit.
Dude, you're skipping. We haven't talked about Cabba or Magetta.
Well, Magetta is not really. Magetta is like.
Magetta. Okay, no, I can say a couple things. The Magetta fight was great. It was an amazing fight. Can we agree on that?
Magetta's fight was good. He definitely did put up a fight.
No, it was amazing because it was the first time a fight was creative since, like, Dragon Ball.
I feel
we
like...
We haven't had a creative fight in a long time.
I feel like it was undermining, though.
Well, no, I'm saying the fight was good for the sense of the creativity in it. Like Vegeta using his ki to destroy the barrier, heating up the temperature to make Vegeta get tired.
Right.
Because it would be hard to breathe. Stuff like that is what I love, you know what I mean?
Right.
But, yeah, so Magetta was pretty interesting. Like, I absolutely love how it new insulted. How if you insult him verbally, he like just becomes super weak.
he gets upset. That's what it is. His emotions get hurt.
Yeah, he like.
His feelings get hurt.
Yeah, when I saw him just like weeping after fighting Vegeta, I actually felt bad.
I saw a few women fans. I saw a few of the women fans actually saying they felt bad for Magetta.
No, I only felt bad for him. I kind of like, wow. Because I was thinking back in my head, I wonder if Chopper is going to kill him. I was like, he'll be emotionally sad when he dies. Like, I felt a little bad for the guy because he has to deal with a pissed off Chopper. You know what I mean?
Right.
And, you know, that I would feel bad for anybody that had to do that. But let's talk about who next to Hit, or sometimes even above Hit, the fan favorite, Cabba. You go first.
Cabba versus Vegeta was... I mean, it was definitely better than Magetta. But it wasn't... It was built up just to be let down. Like,
but then again,
it was decent.
Was it a fight?
It wasn't even a fight. That's the thing. It was more like a beatdown or a training session.
Yeah, I was about to say it was a training session. It would pretty much be equivalent to when Goku and Gohan fought in the time chamber while training.
I mean, that's the thing. I didn't really like how they just turned the fight into the training session. I like how Vegeta helped him go Super Saiyan. But they ended that fight way too quickly.
That is true. They ended it too quickly. The ending didn't make any sense. I mean, from a writing standpoint. From a story
I didn't like. I didn't like how Cabba's power equaled Vegeta's in base form. Because I felt like that wasn't... Like, Godki feels like a... You know, you think of God Ki as like a switch, on and off, right?
Yeah, they can turn it off and on. Like, Vegeta right now, Vegeta when he fought Cabba, I would say maybe a little bit weaker than Frieza?
No.
Because according to Battle of God, Goku in his base wouldn't be able to beat Frieza. So, I'm saying Vegeta is weaker than Goku.
But Goku in his base, which was somewhat equal to Vegeta in Resurrection of F, kicked Final Form Frieza's ass.
While using Godki.
Right. Oh, we're talking about if that switch is like turned off, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, that makes more sense. Yeah.
I'm with saying that, switch off, there is no way in hell Vegeta would use a Gaki in that fight.
Yeah, with that switch off, literally their power is way lower than you would think it'd be. Like,
well, yeah, with that switch off, Goku can't even be Final Form Frieza.
Right. I mean, no.
No,
I mean,
also, you need to consider that Final Form Frieza was way stronger.
Right.
Like, I'm talking about Namek Frieza. Goku right. couldn't be that in his normal no-god ki be. In his Saiyan Beyond God form, Vegeta would destroy Kai.
Relatively speaking, Goku would be twice as less strong than Frieza. I don't know how you want to put that.
Two times
in Battle of Gods. He yeah. would literally, Frieza would be twice as strong as Goku in Battle of Gods, is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
From the looks of it. So that's how big the difference is. But this is a review, this isn't a discussion. So
yeah,
let's go on.
But going on to that was, so I didn't really, as you were saying, I didn't mind them going all out because as I explained, I look at it, I think Vegeta wasn't using Gaki.
Oh, yeah, I don't mind either. And if he wasn't, I can understand that. But, I mean, I feel like it was too shortly ended. It was like,
it was too
could have
short.
Kept it going.
It was too short, and I, no offense, I feel like Kaba's transformation was garbage.
I don't feel like it was garbage. I just feel,
I feel like it was like up there, like the Goten, the Trunk, and like Gohan, like really bad, lame reasons. You know what I mean?
You mean Gohan Super Saiyan 1 transformation, not 2?
Yeah, Gohan's garbage Super Saiyan 1 transformation. Was I not even sure if that was in the manga?
It was. I don't think it was. I think that was filler.
I think it may have been the manga, but after
no, time, I mean, like, the first time he sort of got it was in the manga, but obviously when he was in the time chamber and he's walking around with it, no, that wasn't in the manga.
No, yeah, but the first time he got it was.
Oh, yeah. But to put it bluntly, it could have been better. The transformation was literally too anticlimactic. Like,
that's
you
the
could
whole
see
point,
you could...
There are so many great ones. Gohan, Super Saiyan 2. Trunks going when Trunks powers up after against Cell, you know what I mean?
Right.
Like
there's Goku
Super Saiyan,
Saiyan for the first time.
Super Goku Saiyan 3 Goku Super Saiyan 3 Goku. There's a Goku transformation into Super Saiyan against Cell.
Was that really that climatic though? But
no, but it was a transformation that was epic. I mean, all so good.
I feel like the week before, they sort of built it up by showing Kaba go Super Saiyan, and everybody's like, oh, this is going to be so cool. When it finally comes up, it's so anticlimactic. Everybody's just...
Well, no, I feel like Vegeta could have done more. Like, maybe you could have had one of Kaba's family members be there watching, and you could have had Vegeta fire a Ki Blast at them.
Like, that would have been too far, I think.
No, but it would have been like either you become strong enough to stop the Ki Blast or they die. And then Kaba would transform into the Super Saiyan and he would have that anger and that need and then he could block it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like that would have been great, right?
I mean that could have been better. Not
no,
the best,
but I mean
but
just, no, but it still would have been more climactic.
Right.
It would have been cooler because you could have had this whole state of like Kaba just like staring at the Ki Blast as they get closer and had to go into like slow motion like they did with Teen Gohan. Then you could have done something with that.
Right.
But again,
we're going too much about Kaba. We can't keep this too long.
Okay.
Right, let's
we should talk quickly. We kind of have to because it's Vegeta, the fanboy will rage if we don't talk about the fact about what we saw Vegeta quickly at the teacher. I like teacher Vegeta. Found it very entertaining.
I like
this mentor Vegeta.
I mean, it's okay.
I do love the Kaba relationship though. He's like He like Vegeta Sensei. He like, do not call me that.
Okay, Vegeta Sensei.
I know. He actually it reminded me of like Genos, or was it Genos?
It reminded Genos. It reminded me of more of Yukimura.
No, it reminded me of Genos because Saitama's just like, what? Like, Saitama does not care, but he called it Sensei.
By the way, for those people who don't know by now, which you should, Genos is from One Punch Man, and then Yukimura is from Sengoku Basara.
That's so right. Like, about that.
These aren't Dragon Ball Z characters we're talking about. Don't go looking for some random characters that don't even exist in the Dragon Ball universe. These aren't Dragon Ball Z characters.
Yeah. No, but I did like that. I mean, I feel like we do need to talk about the elephant in the room real quickly. Vegeta going to go to Planet Salad. So hype for that.
I mean, we don't even know how that's going to happen, when it's going to happen. Like, with this new arc coming up...
Yeah, let's not say too much, because this is an arc review. We don't want to spoil people.
Yeah, but with the new arc coming up, I'm not going to spoil anything. I'm just saying, with the new arc, we don't know where things are going to go.
Yeah.
So, things could go in a completely opposite direction, and Vegeta going to Planet Salad could literally be, like, 3 years from now. Because honestly, it looks like they're just trying to set up Dragon Ball Super to be a pretty long series, which I don't dislike, but if they do it wrong, Dragon Ball Super being a long series is going to be a downfall instead of an increase for their money intake.
That
so
is,
they need to get this right.
After, I don't 100% agree with that, but that's for another time.
Right, they do need to get this right, though, so that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, let's just move on to fan favorite. The man of the hour.
Manaka.
Damn it, man. You ruined it.
Wait, was it actually Manaka? Because I was being sarcastic.
No. I was going to... Oh, screw it. You know what? Screw it. I keep it at then. I'm not editing it out. This is hilarious. Just save it to video.
So what was it?
It was Hit, of course.
Oh yeah, that dude.
I mean, how do we even begin?
First of all, I felt like it wasn't bad that he wasn't strong. I mean, no, it wasn't bad that he wasn't weak, is what I mean. But at the same time, fans were complaining that he was too strong to actually survive a Kamehameha from Super Saiyan Blue times 10 Kaioken. But first, before we get onto that,
more of a problem with that he's so much stronger than anybody else on the team.
I don't have more of a problem with that, but well, the
I'm
fans
I'm
kind of
just like, wait, there was only one person that you could find in your whole universe at this level. Wow, you're a god, Champa. Vado, you have the same ability as Whis. What the hell is going on?
Right.
Aren't you telling me it's like everybody, then like a super science, and then it's Hit that can fight on par with that? In my opinion, could beat Champa.
Right. First of all, before we go on to this, because we are getting ahead of ourselves, we need to get one thing out of the way before we do continue, because I think people will be a little upset if we don't talk about this, since it's an arc review. Vegeta being vastly nerfed.
Yeah.
What was your thought on the fact that...
Well, I didn't really realize it at first until I saw people complaining about it.
I didn't realize it until I saw Goku fight Hit.
I never noticed a difference. I didn't notice it until he did the cow. I always thought that was up to the information Goku had. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, up until the Kaioken, I firmly believed that Vegeta would have done just as well if he had known about the Tokutobashi or the time.
Yeah.
But no, and that's the weird part, you know what I mean?
Right.
Like, I'm looking at this guy kind of like, I'm confused, what, I don't understand, like,
let me just,
no,
I mean,
here's the big plot hole, the big plot hole is, Vegeta didn't know about this technique. That is my main problem with this.
What do you mean?
Oh, well, you try spending 3 years, well, which of us, spend 3 years in a room, nothing but a void together.
Oh, you mean Goku's
and,
technique.
I will learn how to clean an entire mansion in 30 seconds, and you won't even notice. Even though we're living together in a dimension isolated from everybody, and it's just in a white void.
I actually do want to say one thing, and this might annoy Vegeta fans, but it's my personal opinion. I honestly, most of the time, I was just thinking that maybe Goku had the upper hand because he was more skilled at fighting. And I mean, I know a lot of people disagree with that, but that was personally what I thought, because maybe Goku, I was like, okay, maybe Goku's just doing better because he's more skilled at fighting, because Goku seems to, you know.
No, I feel like you're wording it in the wrong way. Goku was doing better because he was skilled enough that he had the skill that he needed, that all he really needed was the information. And I think it's the same with Vegeta.
Oh yeah, it's the same, but that's
so
what
like
I'm saying,
can we both agree that if you had given Vegeta that information, he would have done relatively well.
Oh, he would have done relatively well. I was actually a little surprised at how Vegeta just charged in instead of thinking first. Vegeta's not that sort of person. That's definitely why I thought they nerfed him.
Well, no. You also need to... But, dude, how much weaker have these people been? I mean, like, I even said it before.
Mean?
It's hard to be...
True, Vegeta...
It seems a little unbelievable that you have people... The strongest person there... Besides, hit with like Kaba. I mean, it's a little disturbing, right?
Yeah.
It's like if I would go to Vegeta, I wouldn't even want to go to planets now. I'd be like, keep me away from this universe that only had like one person that's strong in it.
Right.
No, but yeah. So you were saying?
Like I was saying was, I mean, I felt like Vegeta shouldn't have just charged it. I felt like that wasn't him.
No, definitely a little out of character.
I definitely felt like Vegeta could have done better, but I don't think he would have survived longer than Goku if Hit would have done the evolve with the time skip thing. Because it's definitely Goku's the only reason Goku survived that is definitely because of the Kaioken.
Oh yeah. And by the way, I'm just gonna say it right now. I do not really like his ability, but the more I thought about it, I do not like that ability at all.
What do you mean?
The whole improving wall in your fight, it's too broken.
It is broken.
It's like
mid-fight Zenkai boost.
No, it's like mid-fight Zenkai boost, but on steroids. I mean, yeah, do you have any idea? What kind of thing? Look at how quickly Hit was improving during that fight.
Not only that, if you notice how short in time he closed the power gap that was created, he literally closed that power gap within, like, minutes.
And that was
not
a,
even that.
That was a 10-time power gap.
Right.
Debatably higher, because Goku was weaker before.
Right.
So, yes, but let's just talk about the fight as a whole now, and Hit as a whole. What my personal favorite thing was when Hit and Goku did that fist bump, they jumped back and charged at each other. I loved that scene.
My personal favorite scene had to have been when Goku did one of the most iconic things he's ever done, he seemed to have done so far in the series. It's iconic mainly for the reason that he hasn't done it in so long, and it's very rare for him to do so, but he flew through a Kamehameha. I mean, I think I've only seen him do it once in the series. And it was amazing just seeing Goku do, like, that flying punch through the Kamehameha. Very rarely do you see the character who's shooting the attack fly through their own attack to do an extra. You get what I'm saying, right?
Yeah, like taking the damage of it.
Right. I mean, no, I don't think when the character flies through their own attack, they take damage. But very rarely do you see a character use such strategy that they fly through their attack midway to attack the person who's at the end of it.
Yeah, even though he could have just teleported.
True.
But, oh, can we talk about the Kamehameha? Just the way it was animated and how it was actually animated like they used to do it?
Oh, yeah, that was a good, very good scene. Amazing, amazing.
I never seem to have, like, a problem with the actual way they animate the Kamehameha.
It's the way they make it seem. Like, they make it seem like the Kamehameha just pops off into a ball after the character lets it go.
No, also the way they angle the charging of it.
They do.
Another one Goku did it against Dao, and you saw him from, like, Dao's point of view in the air pulling his hand back.
Right.
You saw the blue thing appearing, you saw him tossing his arms up, like, you saw it happening from a different angle. With this, it kind of just, like, ha!
And like, then it's over.
But they
did do that this time, which was great. It was very important to pull this off right, and it seemed like they did pretty. They put effort into it. Yeah.
They wanted to make it epic, but now let's just talk about the character. And yet, like, personality, character. What do you think of him?
He's obviously mysterious, and a lot of characters seem. I mean, a lot of people. Or fans seem to like him already, but the problem with Hit is he could turn out to be a very broken character, especially if he's an enemy.
I swear to God, if they make Hit a villain.
If Hit eventually becomes a villain, he could be a very broken villain, which honestly just wouldn't be good. For the story, at least plot. That would be a very cheap plot. Not only that, but Hit seems to be a very broken character. So if he's an ally, it would also be a very horrible plot. Because him being an ally to the Z Fighters would mean he would help them when fighting an enemy. If that's true and Hit does improve as fast as he seems to, that means that
then they need to find an enemy that will improve faster than Hit.
Yeah, but that's just horrible plot.
Yeah, bad writing, but then again, but then Kai boosts them. You know what probably happen?
What?
It'll be real. Hit will be a good guy. He'll help out in that dark. If he shows up, at least. And then. It will be gone. The improved thing will be gone. Same thing as last time.
I don't think Hit's going to show up for at least another two arcs.
I don't know, Toriyama didn't get the kind of person to do, like, the whole characters appear, and they don't appear for two arcs, and they appear, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but, I mean, I'm not to try to spoil anything, I'm not gonna, but, like, from what we know about this arc...
No, but this is Toriyama, he always finds ways to bring characters in.
He does find ways to bring characters, but I'm saying, if you're looking at it from a good plot point, if this ends up being a good plot, he won't bring Hit back for at least another arc or two.
True.
Right, so, I mean...
I know some people are bothered by that, so before we move on to this, like, talk of the overall, this general, quick little thing. Hit...
Omni-King?
No, this is important. People have a serious problem with Goku and Hit not going all out.
Okay, see, these people have to realize... Goku seemed to have went all out, which is ridiculous.
Goku did go all out.
It's ridiculous, but Hit didn't go all out because he can't kill them.
Hit's not allowed to.
They've explained to this. They've explained it in the show. Hit's an assassin. His attacks are meant to kill. If he can't use those attacks, he can't fight at his full potential.
No, but people have people have argued that Goku and Hit may never have a serious fight now.
From what we know,
you know, because Hit seems to like Goku now, right?
But listen,
so why would Hit want to murder him?
I guess that's true.
It's the same thing with Vegeta. It's like Vegeta wants to beat Goku, but does Vegeta want to like kill Goku? Like charge a galaxy?
I think Hit will just end up being one of those. I think Hit will just end up being another one of those protagonists that just, you know, ends up eventually developing his attacks to not be so lethal.
At the end.
Right.
You mean like, yeah, maybe, but no, but then that would still make them weaker.
It wouldn't make him weaker because...
No, because the attack is designed to kill. It would be like if Krillin decided to make the Kienzan or Destructo Dick less sharp.
That's true.
It would be like, yes, the attack is less deadly, but if it's not sharp, then it's not nearly as dangerous. If Hit made the attack, then guess what? It wouldn't be an assassination technique.
True.
It wouldn't be as powerful. It wouldn't suit his fighting style. It wouldn't make sense. So yeah, we may not get to see them fight all out, and that kind of
act. They could work something out with the next plot. I'm not gonna say anything about it, but they could work something out with the next plot where it could work.
Or they could always just pull a Majin Buu arc and just use mind control.
True.
I mean, would it really surprise me? They did it with Vegeta. People wanted a remap between Goku and Vegeta. For some reason, I have a feeling Hit is going to replace Goku. Is going to end up replacing Vegeta.
I felt like that too. I wanted to mention that, but I didn't want to piss anyone off.
No, I feel like Hit could replace Vegeta because I feel like he can fill the role. And to be honest, I like Hit more.
I do like Hit a little more than Vegeta.
I like him a lot more because. Vegeta, I don't think, has had enough character anymore. You know what I mean?
Vegeta doesn't have character. He's very stale, in a way.
No, I know. He used to be better. Even earlier in Super, he was better. In the Slice of Life episode, like, everything prior to this arc, he wasn't as bad. But in this arc, Vegeta, ruining an arc or two, is kind of a good thing. But... No, in its arc, Vegeta would kind of just, like, pissed off the whole time. You know what I mean?
He seemed too tensed up, which is exactly what the...
No. It wasn't just like he was tensed up. It was like the whole time he was just ready to leave. You know, like the whole time he was just like, I'm annoyed. I don't want to be here. You're all annoying. I want to go train. You know what I mean?
That did seem like what it was.
It seemed like he was not interested, and he was pissed off that he had to be there.
True.
So, I mean, who knows with that? But what else is there to talk about? Was there anything... Oh, right, Monaka.
I think that was more comedy relief. I think we could just brush that off as a comedy relief.
No, it was still part of the arc, and I have, and you know damn well I have a lot to say about this.
That's okay. Exactly why I wanted to just call it comedy relief.
Yeah, we're not doing that crap. Okay, so we go over something for a minute here. What?
Oh, God, here comes ranting.
No, I have a couple questions for you.
Okay, what?
What was Goku's goal in Dragon Ball? Overall, what was his goal that he achieved by the end of the series?
Oh God, ranting. Okay,
no, I'm asking you legitimately. In Dragon Ball, like the original Dragon Ball when he won the Tenkaichi Budokai, what goal had he achieved by winning that tournament?
To be the strongest.
Hooray! So, where was Monaka then?
Nowhere.
Was he still, was he any less motivated than he is now?
No, I mean, Monaka was still delivering some, shipments back then, most likely.
Okay, interesting. No, but I'm being legitimate. It doesn't make any sense. Like, the idea of Monaka annoyed me because, one, it doesn't make sense. Two, Monaka had no character. And don't argue with me on that. He's not funny. How many speaking lines have Monaka had?
What, like 13?
Yeah, I mean, and one of them he just started crying in, and then there was a time he started crying.
And then there was a time he started crying.
And then there's the nipples.
Somebody made a joke about that. Monaka, the almighty nipple lord. Best character, Dragon Ball Super.
Yeah, probably the worst. No, but...
If you guys can't tell, this guy seriously hates Monaka.
Oh, I hate Monaka. I have a burning, hating passion for Monaka. I hate him more than Chi-Chi. I hate him more than Poir. I hate Poir. Poir. Most useless cat ever. Yeah.
He's more useless than that cat that Mr. Popo just randomly happened to have at one point in the series. And yet, it was never seen again.
Oh, yeah. So useless. But I going to say, Poir, you're so useless that happy. You're more useful, buddy. I don't know if people will get that reference. No, but...
I don't know. They look pretty similar.
And you're happy like the cat from Fairy Tail. Yeah. No, but why don't we move on to... What happened next? We can't just talk about character.
What do you mean?
It's an arc. Was the arc just the character just standing in a blank room doing things?
No, I mean, we talked about basically relatively what went on in the arc. We talked about the fights.
No, but when you're about to skip over Ciampa trying to murder people.
I mean, it wasn't that big of a deal. It was literally like a 5 second.
But what did you think about Hit being afraid of Ciampa?
That just means Ciampa is stronger than Hit.
Really? But what did you think about that? I think that's a load of crap.
I think it's a load of crap too, but you know.
Because who is stronger? Beerus is stronger than Ciampa, right?
Yes.
That was stated.
According to Vados, Vados says you can judge who's stronger based on their physique.
And that's easy to tell who he's talking about then.
Right.
So, Beerus is stronger than Ciampa. So, that leaves me a question, something. If Goku is around Beerus' level in Super Saiyan Blue, without the Kaioken.
Right.
And Hit can keep up with Goku Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken times 10. And you expect me to believe he can't beat the guy that's weaker than Beerus? You expect me to believe that? You honestly expect me to believe that for even a second?
Plot holes for days.
There was also the way Goku's body reacted to the Kaioken. I don't really think that was right.
What do you mean?
Last time I checked, that is not what happened. His muscle became more inflamed from the Kaioken.
But this was and a more key-controlled form, remember?
No, but still. Last time I checked, the side effects of the Kaioken were different. Did it cause and your arm to have a spasm attack?
But his arms were having a spasm attack while he was using it last time.
They were?
Yeah, remember his arms were like bulking up more and more the longer he used it?
True. So why did it happen after the Kaioken this time?
Because I just told you, remember, Super Saiyan Blue is a more key-condensed, controlled form.
But he was out of Kaioken when he deactivated. What was like a side effect of using the Kaioken in Super Saiyan
Blue?
Because effective after he powered down?
Yeah, because remember, once he powered down, he wasn't controlling all that key anymore.
The key was gone. He had powered down. He was in his base.
Right? What about it?
Unless the Kaioken aura is around his body, unless he's actually using the technique, Why would it be a set thing in space? He deactivated the Kaioken before he deactivated Super Saiyan Blue, if I remember correctly.
Right, but what about it?
So Kaioken
It's like
God.
One of those. It's like one of those. It's like one of those delayed reaction things, bro.
That is the dumbest. I mean,
he is gonna in the next episode. We know what's gonna happen. I'm not gonna say it, but you know what's gonna happen. So I mean, it's reasonable.
If you read the spoiler, to go. If you want to know what happened, go read the spoiler. But so what were your thoughts on I want to start wrapping this up. So, Omni King.
What about him?
You start. Opinions on Omni King and all the stuff he was saying. And
okay, so no one knows if
I want to just clear this up. I see.
No. I'm not even going to clear this up. I'm going to give you such a simple explanation.
I want to clear up his name for a second. His name is not King Zeno. That does not make any sense.
Okay, let me explain this. Zeno means Omni King. It translates
to Omni King. Zeno means everything. Literally.
No. According to Herms, I think how he explained it is Zen is all equals all, and O means King.
Yeah, so King. So it's pretty. So what?
And all.
Frank's saying is the meaning of the name Zeno is King of everything.
Right, literally King of everything. Because
Frank's saying is that name wouldn't make sense.
Yeah, if you said King Zeno, it would literally just be saying King Omni King.
No, it would be King. It would be like King. It would be like King Everything King.
Basically.
Yeah, it's like, it's a terrible name. So, you can either call him Zeno or Omni King. Pick one.
Right.
You can continue now. I felt like people need to know that.
But what I'm going to clarify is, just because he said he could have all 12 universes destroyed, doesn't mean he can do it, doesn't mean if he can't do it, but until you have proof or until he says he personally can do it, just don't go making accusations. I'm seeing memes of Goku and all these DC Universe fighters, Marvel Universe fighters fighting each other, and then Omni King just pops up, and this is a meme. Omni King just pops up and says, "I'm stronger than all of you." It's a meme that I'm getting tired of. No one knows if this guy's actually stronger than enough to do it. He could be. But it's
he can 100% do it, but that doesn't mean he's strong enough to do it.
That just means he could. It could be his power.
Okay, no, I'll tell you what. I have the best way to explain this. All right, best simplest way anybody can understand. You have the Bible. It's pretty much like basic concept. God created human life, right?
Yeah, but then again, that concept can be challenged.
No, but let's just look at this. But, so, that means he could end it. But does that mean by ending it, but would he be ending it by going onto Earth and just charging a giant ball of death and throwing it at the planet? No, he could just do it.
He could just rapture them.
No, it would be like, snap your fingers. You know what I mean? It'd be like,
no, it's called the Rapture.
No.
It's an actual thing.
You're making it more confusing. Be quiet. You could just snap his fingers and be like, I created it. I have power over it. So I choose whether or not I continue to exist and live. That is the way the Omni King's ability could work. He has power over it. He's choosing whether or not it continues to survive and live.
Right.
Am I right?
You are not wrong.
No,
you are not absolutely
or maybe he is a
right.
God. Maybe he could charge up a giant ki blast and maybe he could just charge a ki blast.
Let me just put it this way. He's a king. A king never has all the power. So don't just assume he has the power.
True.
Like, literally, just because you're a king doesn't mean you have the power. He's the king of all. Doesn't mean he commands all. Just means he has the ability to tell people to basically destroy all. He has
two assistants. No, I also want to point out that it could also be an ability.
It literally could just be the snap of a finger, like he said.
Yeah, so, it could literally be like how we can look into his staff.
Okay, let's just get over this. They should understand by now. If they don't, then it's just hopeless.
Yeah, they don't. So the Omni King shows up. You know, what do you think of the Omni King in general? The character, I kind of liked him.
I liked him. It was funny that he sounded so childish. I loved his voice.
I was like, I was actually a little surprised when I heard it. I was like, I'm actually surprised how I hired another voice actor. I actually thought they were just gonna call the guy that does Pika, and was like, hey.
You know what? I did like it though. His voice did seem childish, but it seemed like that innocence that you would never think has power over everything. Which is conception, which I like.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, you figure Omni King, oh, he's going to be this big,
it's something bad, tough Toriyama guy. Would totally do.
Right, and it's also conception.
I think Toriyama, I have a gut feeling Toriyama picked out that voice actor.
Actually, it's on Konzenshu. They explain who he is and where he came from, but I can't remember if he picked it out or if Toei just hired him. I think he did pick it out, but I didn't really read it. It's an article.
I think Toriyama has a tendency to pick out the voice actor.
Yeah, but it is an article in Konzenshu that explains who his voice actor is and where he came from. Yeah, so you can go check that out. Yeah,
Konzenshu, as always. Link in the description. Go support Konzenshu. We say it every damn time.
We basically do, yeah.
Yeah, no, but I feel like it's time that we said it. Multiversal tournament.
You just ruined the next arc.
What do you mean?
No, I'm joking. I'm being sarcastic.
Oh, no. Okay, I'll tell. I have some spoilers for you guys, okay? Okay, so the next arc, Goku will fight. There.
Literally, okay, I'm not trying to spoil anything, but, okay, just spoiler alert, just in case people do consider this a spoiler, but is literally the next arc isn't even a universal tournament. They're like, oh, we should have a universal tournament reveal. Next arc isn't even a universal tournament.
Yeah, you're right, it isn't. No, but, and honestly, if you don't know what is going on, I you must not have any type of social media account.
Right.
And even then, it would be kind of hard not to know.
You would have to have you would actually have to have some sort of social media to watch this, so. I mean, not an account, but you'd have to be on social media to watch this. If you haven't heard about this, I mean.
Yeah, true, but no, but okay. Overall point here is that I don't want to talk about this. No, what are your thoughts on the idea of the multiverse? Like, did that bother you when you were watching the episode?
When I thought about it, like, I heard about it and I got excited, and then I calmed down and I was like, wait a minute.
That sounds like a really, really bad idea.
No, I didn't think it was a bad idea, but it was just like, wait a minute. This could be bad, or this could be good. And then when they reveal the next arc, like, what the next arc's going to be, I'm just like, what happened to the tournament? Like, where's that going? And then in my head, I was like, well, this is good, because that means they're not just going to have one arc after the new material. They're not just going to have two arcs and then end it. This definitely means there's going to be more arcs, which is good for us, unless they do bad, because people really won't enjoy it. But it's good that they're going to have more arcs.
I don't care if it's Dragon Ball. If we're going to get content, I want good content.
Right. So it's good that we basically do have a confirmation we're going to have more than just two arcs for this series. But the problem is, how will these arcs play out? And if they do play out, will they literally just intertwine and then create one huge
aspect? I love how much you diverted from the actual topic.
I completely forgot. I mean, like, I get wrapped up. But basically,
I mean, well, you know, like,
the point is, this tournament arc is not the tournament arc they're talking about is not the next arc, and it might not even happen. there's plenty of things that have been said that could happen, but have never happened.
Or things that have been brought up, and Stuper had the habit of giving out an idea and ripping it to pieces.
And I'm not
having the Nexian Book of Legend.
I'm not trying to be that kind of guy, but they could do this in the form of a movie. They could just do an arc in the form of a movie, like as a side thing.
Yeah, I don't know. Okay, now let's just quickly talk about multiverse. Let me give my opinion. You know what I mean? Quickly, I want to end up soon. But I think when I heard that, I was like, oh my god, please no. I was not excited. I was more like, oh god, no, not this. This is just a bad idea.
Yeah.
Because I'm not going to go too into detail, but I've already done it before, and I was going to do a whole video on it. But go back and just watch the theory. Toriyama can barely work with, like, 10 characters.
Let alone about 70.
Yeah, because if the Omni King is being literal when he says, I want to do this same tournament, but with all 12 universes, that is 70 characters. Or more, possibly, depending on the way things work out. Who knows? Maybe some Gods of Destruction will be bringing guests. Yeah, there could be other side characters, like the guests. You know what I mean?
This dude could literally just have, like, a whole royal audience for this fucking tournament.
Forget about that, dude. What of an university... One of the competitors from a universe could invite their entire family.
Like, a family of like 28 people.
Yes. You see my point here?
13 of them are children.
Okay, you see, this is a point.
This is my cousin, my second cousin, my third cousin, my brother, my sister, my mama mia, my daddy, my papa.
Wait, why would he say my mama mia or my papa just thinking Japanese?
I was making a
Kachan really would be Tochan and Kachan. Yeah. No, but moving on to past my weeaboo factor. There is only one more thing to talk about.
Zarama and Super Shenron?
Zarama and the Court. The Wish.
No, not Zarama. Zarama and Super Shenron.
Technically, yeah. New start.
Wait, do you know the difference? Before we get
on. Of course I do.
The difference? Go on, then. What's the difference?
Zarama is the creator.
Okay, good. I'm glad you know this. Because some people are getting confused thinking Zarama is Super Shenron.
No, I used to be confused.
Yeah. Zarama is the creator of Super Shenron. Yeah. And I have no idea where the name came from, but apparently the fandom's using it, so I'm just going with it.
No. It came from, I think, not the Omni King. What's the other guy's name?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I got the all-knowing one.
Zuno. Yeah. Wait, Zuno said his name Zarama? I don't remember that.
Yeah, Zuno. But, you know, he probably said it in his, like, 2-minute monologue about the Super Dragon Ball.
He probably did say it, and all of us just forgot about it, because that was such a...
And the biggest problem with that episode was... They made the guy big too fat. So he probably just dropped the name, and we just didn't notice. So, let me think. I'm trying to remember. We actually did skip an episode when we were talking about that. So we'll talk about this after we're done with this, but... Super Shenron, what did you think of all that?
Super Shenron?
The whole thing. I know there's something about the episode that you probably want to say.
What about Super Shenron looked really
good. You probably would have rubbed something about the Super Dragon Ball in my face.
Oh, I actually did predict that the nameless planet was going to be the last dragon, Super Dragon Ball. And like, I remember One Piece Nation saying, that's a good theory, but I honestly don't think that's it.
Dude, I always had this mindset where I was like, what if somebody wished for something while on the planet? The Dragon Balls are surrounding it.
And I literally said, I was like, bro, this Dragon Ball, this planet is literally the Dragon Ball. I know it. And you kept trying
and
to come
actually,
up with a reason why.
I don't think anybody ever said I wish in this entire tournament.
True.
And also, it wouldn't have mattered, though, because it needs to be done in the language of the god.
True. Which, by the way, who doesn't know, the language of the god is actually just backwards Japanese.
Yeah, with I bet new people like Herbs and all those other people and all the Japanese fans found very funny.
Yes.
That was probably part of the joke.
The language of the gods is literally backwards Japanese, which is most likely pretty fucking hard to talk, pretty hard to pronounce. But if you can speak backwards Japanese, I'm pretty sure you can confuse a shitload of people.
Dude, did you even hear Waste? Okay, can we talk about that?
It was like Xenomane, and I don't even know how the fuck he was saying it. It was so weird. That voice actor's gotta be so goddamn talented. They were so good at speaking backwards Japanese. Is that like a natural thing?
I don't know. All I know is I was trying to enjoy the moment, but I was just laughing at the talk. Just thinking of the way
his... Because he was saying it in such a weird way. Like, he said it in such a squeaky, weird-ass alien kind of voice. He was like, I'm like, what the fuck?
I would like to assume he had to do that. Like, probably because he was speaking backward Japanese.
Yeah.
Like, it may have been like, I can do it, but this is the way the voice will sound. Like, if he wanted to do an English voice.
Right.
Yeah, but no, so... Well, first of all, Super Tenkaichi.
Beerus' voice actor seemed to have been able to do it perfectly fine without making it sound weird.
Yeah. So, but what do you think about, Super Shenron? And, like, his whole entrance theme and all that.
Before we go into Super Shenron, I just gotta say, whoever's dubbing this, when they do dub it, is gonna have a fucking problem with that arc when they have to do the backwards Japanese.
No. See, no
they're probably gonna do backwards English, to be honest.
Which I can't wait to hear.
But, Super Shenron was amazing. I loved it, but,
I mean, I felt like it was a little dragged out. Like, the whole summoning thing.
Yeah.
I mean, you're like when he's, like, going around the universe, and then they're going inside of him. I'm just like, isn't this a little much?
Right.
Like, I know he's a god. I know he's the dragon god, but this is getting a little overboard, right? Like, I feel like it's a little overboard, a little too much, you know what I mean? And his design was good.
People are complaining about his design, which really surprises me.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like he should have been a more normal size, and he should have just been in front of them. Like, instead of him being, like, gigantic, like... He was so big, I don't even think Goku could kill him.
Bro, the dude was literally, like, fucking the size of... Almost the size of the entire, like... I think they said he was, like, what? Literally bigger than galaxies or something like that?
I actually was under the impression that...
I was under the impression that he was almost as big as the universe.
I was under the impression that... And there was a point where he was visible to all 12 universes.
Really?
Yeah, if you look, there is one thing where it looks like he's like in between something.
It does look like he's in between universe 6 and 7 at one point.
Yeah. Which is like, wow. You know what I mean?
Right.
No, but though, they go with Dinosaurama and they make boat and Viru makes the wish.
Right.
And I guess we should probably recap this a little bit. Bulma asked beer with what he went for, and he ate with dead a bed. Now, I love this scene. What do you think of the scene? I love this scene.
You mean when he wished for Ciampa's...
You mean when he wished for a bed, he wished for a bed. I love the wishing for a bed scene. Like where he's telling Bulma, I wished for a bed.
Oh, I loved that part. That was hilarious.
Yeah, he refused to admit it. Like, he doesn't want to admit that he did something nice for his brother. Because in the end, what did you think of the witch being for her? On Ciampa's Earth?
I like it. I like the concept that he cares about his brother enough to do so.
But do you feel that it was a cop-out?
What do you mean?
And do you feel like maybe it was a cop-out to escape their problem? You know, but they were like, what would be with the writers were like, oh God, what would be with for?
True, it could have been a cop out.
It was like were you really under the impression at any point before that he gave a single crap about Ciampa?
No, not
was
really.
Was there any indication at all?
No.
No, like did that thing blow you away?
It didn't blow me away. I wasn't too surprised, but
no, but you were just like, wait, what?
I didn't like, expect them to really wish crap? For Ciampa's planet to be fixed.
Yeah. I also am not really sure how you can wish for a planet that has similar... How they made that wish. I mean, even though there's no limit, it's still only one wish.
So I think he could have... I think... The best way it seems to me that you could have said it is, I wish for Universe 6's Earth to be similar or almost identical to Universe 7's.
Yeah, but that would still, according... The dragons are normally, at least with Generon, were normally pretty literal. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but I mean, if
so
he wishes...
So if you said identical, he would probably make Earth still look just like Earth. The environment would look exactly the same.
It did.
But that what did that have to do with people? I never understood how restoring Earth brought back the people.
If he said, I wish for it to be similar to Universe 7's Earth, that would also include the people.
I guess that would work.
Right, because Universe 7's Earth has people on it, so if it's similar, it obviously needs... the similar things.
Yeah, like you're all good. I really wish they had given us like a translation for the wish. You know what? I bet you somebody could actually break that. I think I'm gonna ask somebody to break. I think I'm gonna ask Hearn maybe. If he would, I'll tweet him off about Twitter later. He would ever break that down.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm very curious. I'm very curious if it was actually, you know. If it was an actual wish, or if there was just a bunch of mumbo the jumbo. No, but, quickly, in the very beginning of the arc, we forgot to mention Bulma and Jocko. 1 minute, what did you think of the Bulma and Jocko episode?
Horrible, not very entertaining, went by quick, full of fucking shit that doesn't really matter. Horrible.
Nah, but we can all agree it was worth it. They're gonna vomit the titties.
I mean, seriously,
then Athena was all like, oh, I know how they do food, star girl. Now I know that they have a squeeze. Also, the only thing I liked with the comment was the whole like thing about how men can't if a girl kisses him they get more rewarded one regret, is if a guy kisses him they get nothing.
Right.
I know, and Jocko did it anyway. Some people actually speculate Jocko would buy sexual because of that episode.
I think Jocko's asexual.
Really?
I mean, not like relationship-wise, but I think like, you know, private area-wise, stuff like that, you know, I think he's asexual. I don't think he has any sort of sexuality.
But he has a girlfriend.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean he can't be. That doesn't mean he can't have a relationship. He might literally be like asexual, like literally no private area, anything like that.
Okay,
he pees out of his fucking. Jocko pees out of his fucking head. I mean, what do you expect? For all those people who don't know, if you've read Jocko the Galactic Patrolman, he pees out of his fucking head.
And maybe his head is his penis.
Don't go there. Don't go there. Can we end this? End this now before that goes any further.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Okay. So overall arc rating, what would you rate it?
7.5 out of 10.
Really?
Yeah.
Why? Yeah, you had almost
some episodes. Some episodes did make up for its negligence, but you can't excuse one or two good episodes for a whole arc.
That is very true. You can't excuse that. I think I would give it a. No, I give it. You know what? I'll give it a 6 out of 10.
Not surprised. Not surprised.
Only because I feel that I'm review as I'm looking at it and I'm like it was good, but it was not. But we waited too long. It was not worth the wait.
Right. The
and
arc
by,
wasn't
no,
worth
no.
It.
This arc by did not even come close to being worth the wait. Not even close.
Definitely not close.
No,
but
we,
the next arc.
I rewatched a shitty version of Battle of Gods and Resurrection of that for this arc, and it was only like a decent, pretty good, or good. It wasn't great. It isn't fair. You know what I mean?
Right.
And I feel like that is what killed it. But, yeah, do you have anything to say?
Nope,
well, I think now we can talk about predictions from the next arc quickly.
Oh, my God! Okay, I'm joking.
No. So, we all know Broly is going to come back and rule the entire universe. And become black.
Broly, Super Saiyan, Jesus, Buddha, God, end it now.
One, two, three, cut. Broly is going to come back as an African American.
That's who Black Goku is.
Please like, comment, and subscribe for more videos. We'll see you in the Dragon Ball podcast or whatever in the next arc. Yay!